Good evening and welcome to the Allen Performing Arts Center. If you missed our earlier announcements, this is the first of two nights of concerts featuring our guest clinician, conductor, composer, Mr. Brian Balmages. The group that is going to be performing next is the Allen High School Wind Ensemble under the direction of Dr. Philip Abato. They will be performing George Washington Bicentennial by Sousa, The Childhood Remembered by Galante, Love and Light by Mr. Brian Balmages, and Let Me Be Frank With You by Mackie. Please help me welcome to the stage Dr. Abato and the AHS Wind Ensemble.
Thank you.
Good evening. Again, this is the Allen High School Wind Ensemble. My name is Phil Bobato, Director of Bands here at Allen ISD. I'm glad that you can be here for this, really just a celebration of music and really collaboration. You know, when we do these things, it's about the music, it's about the teaching, and it's about the composer. And we're so glad to have Brian Balmages with us this week, and it's just great. And speaking of collaboration, we're so lucky to have such a great band faculty here in Allen ISD. And I'd like to introduce the conductor of the next piece. He's one of the band directors at Curtis Middle School. Please give a big round of applause to Mr. Craig Adams, who's gonna be conducting A Child to Remember. Well, you already met him today a couple times. You're going to see him a couple more times today and tomorrow. But we just want to hear music. And there's a story of this next piece that I would really like Brian to talk a little bit about how this piece came to be and maybe some of the processes and inspiration behind good sections of the piece. So without further ado, I'd like to reintroduce conductor, composer, great educator, Mr. Brian Balmages.
When Lieutenant Elizabeth Elliott contacted me 2 years ago, it was after she experienced one of the most horrible things anybody in the world could experience, and that was the stillbirth of her daughter, Madison, whose heart had stopped beating just the previous day. She was in labor for 8 hours, and during that entire time, all she could think about was how to get through it. And after she was able to dig herself out of that, months later, she contacted me because she could not find music to help her process what had happened. And she asked if I would help her grieve for her daughter, Madison. And thus, Love and Light came to be. Love and Light essentially asks three almost impossible questions. The first question it asks is, what does unconditional love sound like? And I always say, not temporary love, not even this idea of forever love, but literally unconditional forever love. And so you'll hear that in here. You'll also hear in there a little lullaby presented between oboe and piano. That lullaby is based on the chord progression of Ben Folds' The Luckiest. Some of you may know that song. Elizabeth, when she was pregnant with Madison, used to play that on piano to Madison every day. And so I took that chord progression and I created a lullaby out of that. The second question is, what happens when that love is shattered? And originally I used the word broken until I realized that love is never broken. That bond is never broken, but it was shattered. And you'll hear rage, you'll hear anger, you'll hear uncontrolled just moments of just no balance at all. And then the final question, this is the one that always gets me. What does it sound like when a child first sees the face of God? That's a tough one. I was in the process of going through conversion to the Christian faith when I was writing this piece, so I was in the deepest depths of asking this question. And what I will tell you is that while we all hear about trumpets and the beautiful sounds and the harps and all of that brilliance, which is there, to me, and I suspect many of you, the most intimate moments that we have, that first moment that we feel like God is truly present, is when it's just us and God. And so therefore, that moment that a child sees the face of God is going to be the most quiet and vulnerable moment you can possibly imagine. I hope you enjoy this. This is actually going to be the first time I've ever conducted this piece. It was premiered by the United States Army Band. They did a pretty good job. And then later on, I went back and had an opportunity to produce it. And then I was actually in Frisco just a couple of weeks ago working with Wakeland. Some of you may know Wakeland. So now I get a chance to do something that I've been wanting to do for a very long time. So certainly hope that you enjoy this highly emotional yet deeply satisfying Love and Light. Thank you.
I had to talk to the band. That was a pretty good performance. I'm proud of them. Yeah. And I made a programming error. That should have been the last piece. I don't know how you do a piece after that. So we're going to. we're part of a consortium that commissioned a piece by John Mackey called Let Me Be Frank With You. And he wrote this during the COVID lockdown. And the inspiration was Frank Tekeli, Let Me Be Frank With You. I don't know if that's ironic or, it wasn't intended, but John Mackey was our very first resident composer, followed by Frank Tekeli and Brian Balmages. So I guess it's a fitting ending, I guess, but this is a light piece. It's very light. It's reminiscent of Frank's music. You'll hear a little New Orleans in there. It's just really fun. So I hope you enjoy our last piece, Let Me Be Frank With You.